Now, back to Matt Patrick and your morning news.
Okay, Terry's news time is 6:15. Happy Friday. Thanks so much for joining us. Joining me on the phone is Cesar Espinoza. He's with the Immigrant Families and Students in the Struggle. Cesar, welcome to Houston's morning news. You were protesting, or your group was protesting outside of where Mitt Romney was picking up the endorsement from George H.W. Bush in Houston yesterday. What is your beef with Mitt Romney as it applies to immigration?
Mitt Romney has been, first of all, thank you for having me this morning.
Sure.
Mitt Romney has been very vocal about immigration ever since he started running for the president, or he was a pre-candidate for the Republican Party. He's used immigration as a wedge issue to further his campaign with the Tea Party movement and with very anti-immigrant groups. So he has in particularly said that he does not support immigration reform, and more specifically, he has said that he has spoken out against the DREAM Act.
His suggestion was that illegal immigrants self-deport, that they deport themselves back to where they came from and come in the proper way. You don't like that idea?
First of all, that doesn't make sense because you have a lot of people who are already here, and nobody is going to – it's not feasible that people are just going to pick up and go just because Mitt Romney says so. And coming from somebody with a very rich immigrant background, it's very weird that he would put himself in a situation knowing that his family was also an immigrant family.
Well, but I think what he's talking about is the people that are here illegally. I think that we're talking about the people that have come into this country illegally, who want to access some of the things in this country that we pride ourselves on, like education. Is that the problem that you have, that he doesn't want the people that are here illegally to remain here?
I mean, that basically is this our issue. I mean, we understand, in order to understand immigration, you have to understand what the reasons why people migrate and why people come to this country. And we know that there's a lot of people who came because of social necessity, because of basic necessities, human rights necessities. And if they're already here, and if we have allowed them to be here, then we also
have we really haven't allowed them to be here. I mean, they snuck in, snuck into this country, and so I mean, they got here through ill-gotten means.
Not necessarily. I mean, if we look at immigration records, and people have the largest amount of undocumented immigrants in the country have been over state visas. So they have provided them a path to actually come here legally, not illegally.
All right. Well, I think Cesar, now you would agree that's potato potato, correct? I mean, they got here with the visa and then they stayed. So they're still in this country illegally. Would you agree?
They are here without documentation, but it's very important to point out that these people provide a lot of good jobs and a lot of resources to our country. They also contribute. They're not just taken away from the country. They are providing the jobs that some people do not want to do, and even they are suffering. The Hispanic Center came out with a study last year that immigration is basically at a net zero. People are just not coming anymore because economies in both countries, or in a lot of countries, are suffering. So it's important to talk about the truth and to talk about the fact that we do have 12 million undocumented people in this country, which we have to figure out something to do with them. We have to figure out some way to fix the issue. We can't have 12 million people lying in the shadows.
Cesar, hang on for me. We'll come back. We'll do a second segment here. Let's talk a little bit about the DREAM Act, because that seems to be the thing that I hear the most when it comes to Mitt Romney. I think that you and I are probably not going to come to any agreement here in the short time that we have together. It is the DREAM Act that you would like to see passed, correct? Where those children that have been born of illegal immigrants should be able to stay in this country. Do I understand that right?
Well, it's actually for people who were brought here when they were small children. They weren't born in this country. They were born in this country to be citizens.
Yes, children that were born and that were brought to this country as small children. Correct.
Yes.
That is what you want. But what do we do with the people that have, you know, that have born these children? What do we do with the illegal immigrants that brought these small children here? Can they go back? In your plan?
In our plan, absolutely not. I mean, you have you have these people who are, I mean, you're contributing, we're talking about people that are contributing to our economy. We're not saying that, I mean, there's this mixed or the misconceived notion that people are just taking away and feeding off of the system. When in reality, we need those immigrant hands and we need immigrant labor.
Well, Cesar, listen, my grandparents came here. They came through the front door. They also, you know, immigrated to this country, but they came in the right way. I mean, to suggest that people that are in this country illegally are somehow providing some great service to this country is to generalize in such a way that makes this completely unacceptable to most people. I'm not sure that we can say that and get away with it. I mean, I think it's important that we take a look at this situation. We have got to come up with a reasonable way. What about penalizing the people that have been here, making them pay a penalty, making them learn English, and begin that way? Would that be something you could support?
I mean, one of the things we can actually agree on. We do think that if a law were to pass and they were able to pay fines, people will be willing to pay those fines, and a lot of people will be willing to learn English. There's been different studies that have been done that if immigration reform were to pass, it would actually be a boost to our economy because of all the fines that people would have to pay, of all the lawyers' fees that they would have to pay. So would it actually be a positive thing for our economy for us to pass immigration reform?
All right, Cesar.
I encourage people to look into it.
Cesar, I appreciate your time, my friend. Thanks for coming on with us. Cesar Espinoza with Immigrant Families and Students in the Struggle.